We have the opportunity today to really appreciate God's faithfulness to one of our members in a special way. We talk about God being the way maker, the one who helps us get out of situations that we can't even fathom. Well, it's a young lady who is part of our fellowship who knows a lot about being in situations that only God could have rescued her from. And so some of you would have heard her testimony. It's Nikki Fox, and I'm grateful to have her family and other supporters here today to support her. But at the end of it all we can say is, how great is our God? How great is our God? And so she's going to share her story in video. It's going to be a video that we look at, and then after that, the My Ministry that she's a part of is going to minister. And I'm going to sort of set it up like this. I don't think that we're going to preach anything today, all right? So I'm telling you that because I want the ministry that you're going to appreciate over the next little while to sink deep in. Don't just look at it like, oh, wow, that was nice. No, let it minister to you and let you be in awe of just how great our God is, because what God did in Nikki's life, he can and will do in your life. Amen? Amen. So let's take a look at the video, and then we're going to appreciate the ministry of the Mind team right after that.
My life has never been easy, but God has always been with me. As a child, my household was torn apart by divorce and alcoholism. I wasn't raised in the church, but occasionally my granny would take me. My parents gave me a firm moral foundation, despite their personal challenges. Yet, still I rise. At an early age, I got involved in drugs and alcohol, which led downhill to a life of destruction. I became a mother myself of three beautiful sons, Rico, Skaya, and Zachary. But sadly enough, I was unable to care for them. I went to prison not once, but twice. Yet, still I rise. Today, I stand before you 13 years clean by the grace of God. God, in his love, carried me and kept me. He knew the depth of the loss and pain I was about to experience. October 16, 2006, my dad died of cancer. On the exact same date, 3 years later, in 2009, my only sibling, my lovely brother Ryan, was killed in a rural facility. In May 2011, my mom died of cancer. In January 2013, I experienced a loss that the devil thought would have me reject God and serve him again. Rico, my firstborn, was murdered. A loss no mother should have to endure. But God was still with me. He covered me and drew me to him. And that very night, instead of giving up on God and running back to the devil, I surrendered everything to God, the only power that has some power. Because I knew I couldn't do this on my own. That night, I asked God for a forgiving heart and a peace of mind. And I'm here to say that I've been granted both. Yet, still I rise. Since Rico's murder, gun violence has continued to affect my family on every level. Numerous friends of my sons have lost their lives to gun violence, and I've watched their mothers bury them. In 2018, my home was sprayed with 16 bullets. Everyone was home, but no one was harmed. That was only God. Yet, still I rise. In the midst of my trials, God has blessed me with an awesome family. My husband, Clark, of 19 and a half years, my sons, Skaya and Zachary, and stepsons, Alex and Clarky. Thank you for never giving up on me in my mess. Also, my grandson Cassidy King Rico, who has brought so much joy to our family. I'm blessed to have accomplished personal goals, like competing in a bodybuilding competition, running 24 for me, and dancing in the parade. I am also the chairperson of Mom Bermuda, a support group for all females affected by gun violence in Bermuda. Through it all, God had a plan. He has healed me and has used me to minister his love to others. None of this would have been possible without God's grace and mercy. To God be the glory. And we know that in all things, God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. You turned my wailing into dancing. You removed my sackcloth and clothed me with joy, that my heart might sing your praises and not be silent. Lord my God, I will praise you forever. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. The righteous person may have many troubles, but the Lord delivers him from them all. Yet still I rise.
Bible says in Romans chapter 8, verse 35, says this: who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor any else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen? In John chapter 17, verse 3, Jesus Christ says these words, and he describes what eternal life is. Sometimes we have an idea of eternal life in terms of living forever, and all of that's true. It's being with Jesus Christ, no more issues, no more sin, no more all of that stuff. That's true. But Jesus Christ teaches it very concisely, and this is what it says. John chapter 17, verse 3. Now this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. He says, now this is eternal life, that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. What I want to just encourage us all with this morning is simply this: how well do you know God? How well do you know God? We can get used to doing a lot of church, and church is great. We get used to reading our Bibles. You got to read our Bibles. But Jesus Christ puts it so concisely. He says, this is eternal life. Eternal life is what you know about the person who matters the most. That's what eternal life is. What do you know about God? That's what eternal life is. And then he goes on to say, it's also about knowing whom you sent, who is Jesus Christ. So this is what I want to encourage all of us with today. We're not going to be long. Like I said, the ministry, the preaching has already taken place. I don't need to come behind and do anything else. But I got to ask you, the simple question is, what do you know about God? See, sometimes in our circumstances, we can look at a testimony like that, and we see what God has done in Nikki's life, and praise God for her. Praise God. Only God. You know, I've had the opportunity to, amen. I've had the opportunity to hang out with Nikki on some days when I thought I was going through a bad day. And you sit down and you hear, and she shares a little bit about what God's been doing in her life and how God literally saved her. You know, bullets flying through windows and all types of stuff. And so, like, I'm like, well, I don't have any issues when I start listening to what God's done in her life. But sometimes we can determine that God will do that for somebody else, but it won't do it for me. So we can sit in our issue, we can say, well, you know, maybe I made a bad decision, maybe you did, and maybe I deserve to be punished the way that I'm being punished, or I deserve, and we only think, well, God only works for people who somehow are better than I am, who did their quiet time all week, or prayed the right prayer. Listen, God is a faithful God. God specializes in dealing with messes. That's just what he does. He specializes with it. But so what you and I know about God is what's critical. That's going to be the difference between you leaving here and saying, oh, well, wow, God really came through for Nikki, and, oh, wow, God can really come through for me. So this is what I'm going to ask you to do. Just close your eyes. All right, just close your eyes. Whatever your situation is that you are in right now, whatever it is, my situation, I guess, is not all that drastic, but I'll be honest with you. I have been so overwhelmed over the last month. I've just been tired. I've been stressed out. I've been burnt out. And there are days where I just don't feel like another church service. I'll be honest with you. I'm just tired. There are days when, you know, I look at my family and I just see how awesome they are and how much God has blessed me with them. And it just feels like I'm just not pulling my weight. I'm just not cutting it. And it hurts. It's like, God, I don't even know what to do. I don't know how to pray to you. I don't know, like, you want me to show up, and I get that, God, and I don't want to fake this thing. I ain't into that, God, but I need your help, God. And so God's got to remind me, well, Joe, what do you know about me? You know, what do you know about me? We've been through some stuff. You've called on me in times where things were different, granted, and I came through for you. And yeah, it might be difficult, and you might be stressed out, and maybe you do slip up here and there. But don't lose sight of who I am, because what you know about me is the only thing that's going to get you through it. And so God said to encourage me with that. You know, there have been some days where it's just been difficult, just been hard. And I love God. You know, I love what he's done in my life. I love the fact that he has knit me together with an awesome staff at the office and with this beautiful congregation. But I'm going to be honest, some days that don't feel like it's enough. And that's when God's got to just come in and do what he's got to do. Just grace, God, just grace. Hallelujah, Jesus. So I want to ask you the same question that I ask myself often. What do you know about God? You know, maybe you got a degree in churchology and you know church and you can name all the denominations and all of that. Well, yeah, maybe that has its place. But what do you know about God? What do you know about eternal life? Oh, God. So this is what we're going to do. Eyes are still closed. Just pray. Just pray to God. God, I want to know you in a similar way as Nikki knows you. My life's different. I'm not asking you to ask for the same circumstances. No, that wouldn't make any sense. But it's the same God. It's the same power. It's the same love. It's the same grace. He's the same God. Nothing can separate us from his love. But in my experience, what separates me, what makes it feel like I'm separated from God's love, is when I stop thinking about him the way that I should. He hasn't changed. He hasn't moved. But my thinking gets a little warped and weird sometimes. So let's pray. I've done enough talking. Let's pray. Just pray. God, you know my situation. You know my circumstance. I don't want to fake it with you, God. I want to be vulnerable. I want to be open. I want to be honest with you. And I want you to come through in my life in similar ways as you came through in Nikki's life. Let's go ahead and pray that. Let's go pray that right now to God. Hallelujah. This is what I'm going to ask you to do. Would you stand with me, please? Let's just stand together. And we're going to have a short altar call, and I want to encourage you to come forward. I'm just going to pray. There's nothing else to do but pray, okay? So we just read the words of Jesus Christ, who teaches us what specifically eternal life is. It's knowing God and knowing Jesus Christ. And Paul echoes those words and that sentiment in the book of Ephesians. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 17, and the apostle is writing here. He says, I keep asking that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Father, may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation so that you may know him better. So there's one thing to know God, but then we should always be seeking to know him better. Always seeking to know him better. Paul says, I keep asking, I keep praying, I keep pressing in on your behalf, and I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Father, may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation so that you may know him better. So that you may know him better. So I'm going to ask, if you are committing to pursue God in terms of knowing him better, would you just join me down front? God, I just want to know you better. I just want to know you better. Just come down front. We're going to pray. We'll wait for you at the top. You just come down. God, I just want to know you better. I know about you. You've come through for me in some specific ways, and my relationship is growing with you, and I'm excited about that, and that's awesome, and yeah. But I don't want to stop getting to know you. I want to know you better. So that's the altar call this morning. If that's your heart, just come for it. Just come for it. God, I want to know you better. I want to know you better. And I'm on the stage, but my heart is down there. I'm just here because God's asked me to. But we're going to pray together. God, I want to know you better. And I want to encourage you, all right? If you're in the audience there, why don't you just take a step forward? I'm not trying to, you know. But what happens sometimes, this is why altar calls are important. Altar calls don't necessarily change anything. They don't. But it gives your body an opportunity to come under submission to something that you're going to think to do differently. That's why it's important. Because the flesh is jacked up and it will keep you restrained. I know it. It does it for me. But so an altar call is relevant because it's like, God, I purpose to do this. And I'm going to teach my body now and cause it to come alongside with this new thinking. And that's why an altar call is important. That's why. There's nothing super spiritual about it, but it's an opportunity to give notice to your flesh that gets in the way sometimes. God, I'm going to do everything that I can because I want to get to know you better. Amen. Amen. Come on, let's just come right down front. Let's fill in. Others are still coming. Hallelujah, Lord. We bless you, God. We praise you, God. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. God, I want to know you better. Just want to know you better. Yeah, keep coming. Keep coming. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, God. Bless you, Lord Jesus. So as you've come and as you continue to come, let's just pray. God, I want to know you better. You don't have to have any deep, fancy theological words. This is simple. God, I want to know you better. So just pray that. If you're going to come, feel free. Those that are down front already, let's just pray. God, I want to know you better. I want to know you better, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. I bless you, God. I praise you. And I want to encourage you to pray this as well. Sometimes we can determine that in order to know God better, we're going to demand that he remove the thing that's in our lives or cause the circumstances that we don't like to go away, and that way we'll get to know him better. And I'm like that too, so I'm not preaching down to anybody. But it's oftentimes in the midst of those difficult circumstances that we get to know God the best. And so what we need to pray is, God, while I'm in the space that you have me, would you help me to trust you? Will you help me to know you better? Let's pray that right now, right where we are, wherever that situation is. God, help me to know you better in this season of my life. Come on. Let's just all lift our hands. Pastor Evans is going to pray. Well, let's lift our hands, a sign of surrender to our God this morning. Hallelujah, Jesus. We bless you.
Father, we thank you for what we have seen and heard today. And Lord, our whole lives are spent trying to gain knowledge. We go to school, we go to university to gain knowledge, to know how to do something better, God, so that we can get a job that we would like, and so that we can earn a living. But God, you've asked that we should know you better.
Yes.
So that when we get the job that we want, we would operate in it with integrity, that we wouldn't be arrogant, but humble. Because God, knowledge of other things helps us to gain some things, but knowledge of you helps us to live.
Amen. Hallelujah.
And Father, we don't want to just live any old way. We want to live lives that demonstrate that there is a God who is real and he has changed us. Lord, in order for our lives to speak about you, we need to know you. And Father, today we commit and we say we want to know you on a daily basis. We want to learn something about you. Lord, help us not to experience anything without knowing or learning something about you. Often, God, we go through stuff and in our pain and in our whatever it is we're feeling, God, we don't learn the lessons about you that we need to learn. God, I look at Nikki's life. I look at people in the Bible. I look at things that I have been through, God. And Father, I see that every single time I seek you, and desire to know you. You show up and you teach me something about yourself that I need for that specific circumstance. Your word says that you are exactly what we need in every circumstance. But God, oftentimes we get in circumstances and we don't know who you are. Lord, if we are here and we don't know you for salvation, I pray that that person would not leave until they know today that you are a Savior. But God, I pray also for every single one of us who know you in every single situation that we are in. There is something that we need to know about our God. Lord, I just remember growing up with my grandmother. And my knowledge of her would cause me to trust her like nobody else because I knew just who she was and how she operated. God, we should know who you are and how you are. Thank you, God, for giving us everything we need. You've placed your spirit in us. You've given us your word. And you said if we spend time in your word, with spirit would help us to apply the word when we need it. Lord, today, we pray that we would be like Jesus. And that our very food, the thing that nourishes us, would be to do your will. Father, you are God. Lord, I was listening to that song and it says, just from your breath, billions of galaxies were spoken into existence. And Father, I look at my life and sometimes I have been in situations where I struggled and almost believe you were powerless when I know that you did that. Lord, when we need mercy, you are merciful. When we need grace, you are gracious. When we need your power, you show up with infinite power. When we need your wisdom, you give it without finding fault. When we need instruction, God, you give us. When we need direction, you show us where to go. But all of it, God, is determined by whether or not we know you. Because you could give instruction and we don't know you well enough to accept it. You could give us wisdom, but we don't know you well enough to know that it's coming from you. Because we could measure it with our human mindset and decide that that's not wisdom from God. Imagine if people in the Bible did that, how many things that are recorded we would not see today. Joshua would not have marched. Abraham would not have taken his son to be sacrificed. All of those things, God, humanly speaking, they made no sense. This is why we need to know you. This is why we need to know you. Because not every time you speak does it match up to what we're feeling or what we're thinking. We need to know you. Thank you, God. To know you is to know life. It's to know eternal life, but it's also to know abundant life on this earth. God, today, we leave her with a fresh commitment to know you. Not to know about you. Not to know that you exist. But God, to know who you are. To know how you operate. To know what you are capable of. And to know that you are our God. You're our Father. You're our friend. Thank you, God, for today. Thank you, God, that your word was preached. Your word was preached from a screen from a woman who loves you and has trusted you through so many things. Your word was preached by a mind team, God, who spoke truth. And God, today, we leave here, shattered, some of us, broken, but we will rise. Simply because we know you. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen.
This message has been brought to you by Cornerstone Bible Fellowship Bermuda. To connect with us, visit us at www.cornerstone.bm. or if you have a prayer request, email us at prayer@cornerstone.bm.